6. We heard the discussion points by Yang Yao in our dugout reports. Your thoughts, Coach Ron Jacobs?
Well, Alaska's report was kind of interesting. I would never consider when I'm 16 down to be 0-0. I would tell the players that you can't catch up all at once, just playing and gradually we'll catch up. But if they go with the mentality of 0-0, that's not very good. And they don't have 24 minutes to catch up. They got about 23 minutes to catch up with the game.
Ron, it's very clear that Coach Pink Horn is playing a mind game with his players. Coming from that report that given by Anthony Sundai, he touched only on intangibles, only on the abstracts of the game. He didn't talk about how they should stop Sunkist from scoring inside and what kind of pressure defense they need to do on the ball carrier. What do you think, what effect do you think that kind of attack will have on Alaska?
Well, Tim has the best feel for his players, and he must think they're so down that he had to get them up. Forget about the technical stuff, let's do the psychological stuff. But they better screen off, and they better not give up second shots, and they better play some defense and get some turnovers.
Well, on that point, Ron, in the first half, Sunkist had 19 rebounds and 12 for Alaska, and in the offensive rebound, Sunkist had 7, only 4 for Alaska. In turnovers, and this is a surprise, Alaska committing more turnovers than Sunkist, 10-7 in the first half.
Well, and I think there's more than 10 there.
But talk about turnover here for Sunkist opening the second half.
Yes, a traveling violation against Grandison. It looks like Grandison gets that call at least once every game in the series so far. Dodge Lastimoso, he drew first blood and dust.
They need to cut this down to 8, hopefully 6. They can get away with 10 or 12. They've got to make a dent here somewhere.
That's right. Evidently, Coach Pink Horn is this is his best five on the floor. And Hamilton.
And he even has a dance with Jake with referee by the Despot. Had Hamilton been played there.
And we saw Hamilton go over to Coach Derek Kumar. I don't think there was any negative element in that. I think both of them just smiled it off.
I was intrigued by the report of Coach Maniego about Sunkist, especially his line, don't be happy, when he was talking to about Sunkist.
Don't be happy, but worry.
I agree with everything Derek said. That's basically what I would
say. In the first minute of the third, as Lastimosa penetrates, doesn't work. Follow does not also work, but there is a foul spotted by the officials. It is Grandison as the culprit, his first foul.
And I don't understand why Granderson can't be defended. He's not a one-on-one player, doesn't put the ball on the floor very well. He's not a great outside shooter. In fact, doesn't want to shoot it.
That's right.
He can defend it.
He is basically a low-post player, man. And you can defend the low-post player with a double team.
That's right.
You can deny him if you want to play single coverage.
And he's not a great post-up player. I mean,
yes.
He's just a smart player, knows how to play, picks his spots. And you've got to be aware of that. And just keep him going.
Hawkins, meanwhile, dividing his charities. It's a 54-39 third quarter so far, with 10:58 remaining. We're in game number 6, friends. 3-2 lead in the series by Sunkist.
Tim didn't trap there after the basket. Sunkist got such easy shots. Oh,
that's not about an easy shot.
Yes.
Well, an easy jumper there by Berhel Meneses. The defense didn't react.
And Meneses shoots 7-10 this half.
So far, those turnovers won't help.
Hamilton's not a good passer. That pass should have been caught. But his judgment on the passes that he attempts are just not
good.
Incidentally, Amarillo did not score a single point in the first half. One attempt. And that has to hurt offensively for Alaska. You have Johnny Barrientos, who's averaging in double figures in the finals, not able to score at all in the first half.
Well, I think Sunkist has the quickness that would cause problems for Johnny. He's better on their guards, but they will cause him problems, especially if he's not.
Yeah, moving to the clear. This one refuses to trickle in. Curious battle for the rebound. Blackman stretching for it. Grandison picks it up, but Helminese says, let's take it easy. Against Hamilton, inside 10 minutes now, fake, he'll look to pass, inside the 2 minute, rolls off, hooks it back to the wrong party. Big pass to Jeffrey. Licks off.
Must do here in the second half to get back. They've got to be able to step on the gas and get transition points. And they've got to play good defense on the other end for stops.
In other words, really let it all hang out.
Yes. This is going to be the most crucial quarter, I think, for Alaska. If they have to come back, they must come back here.
Outside toss to Gabriel Meneses. The lead is 15 as the shot clock winds down to 3. Boybit sets. Not this time. Follow up. No, the Alubin. Up and in!
Again, getting the job done off the boards, as you see Coach Tim Cole. Sunkist dominating the boards, using that interior muscle, and call another turnover on Alaska. Things could be falling apart here for the Milkmen.
3 minutes have gone by here in the third.
You see the look of frustration on Jeffrey Carriazo's face.
Lob pass to Meneses. Attempt does not work. Here's a chance for Alaska.
That time they bubbled. And then Hernandez is back on.
Bolas will get the bucket. Fallen Victoria. Upboard from Sunkist. Interesting smile on the face of team manager Elmer Young.
Wonder if we can get a second look at that attempt of Giorgio Lastimosa.
It's Victoria now saddled with 3 personal fouls. Both sides have been called for 2 team fouls in this third quarter. 8:41 to go.
This is the kind of game that Alaska likes to play. The tempo now slowly swinging the side of Alaska. Whether they can keep the momentum remains to be seen.
Well, the only way they do that is defense. They've got to get turnovers to run.
That's right.
When they get the turnover, they'll run. But if they don't get the turnover, they can't run.
7:52 remaining. There's Victoria. Barrientos in front of him. Very good shot. Second miss in a row by Victoria. This one, Mike Baron, the lead to 10. Whip pass inside, a bit too strong. Here a little bit, and out the draw, it gives it to Hawkins.
Time out.
And you're exactly right. Derek Bumaren has seen his lead whittled down to 10.
A bit yung last play na yun when the ball was going out and Rio Lubit passed it back. Siguro. That's a nice talking point. We'll replay that. Yeah. We'll ask you.
This is a big time down the floor.
Okay, Coach, you wanted to say?
Well, this is a big time down the floor. We have to break the momentum here of the game. They're trapping. They get the turnover.
Not quite. They got a foul there. 58-48, 7:20. So he's 6.
Let's take a look at this play.
A total of 6 points have been
this
reduced from the lead.
This is a previous play, yes. Send the ball going out of bounds, and Zaldiri Alubit making the mental mistake of passing underneath the ball. Now, what can you say about that, Coach?
Well, the first rule of basketball, you never save the ball underneath your own basket. That's what he did.
And of course, the way he passed it within the shaded area,
exactly,
which
right.
is going to be easy for the opposition to intercept. And we're talking about interception.
Yes.
Here we go. Carriazo has exploded here.
Has been cut down now to 8. 9 explosion, 9 points. Exploding from Alaska. The tap from behind nearly lost. Tap from behind. It's lost again. Alaska.
It's one turnover after another.
Come on, Jojo, run the ball. They had him in transition, and Jojo slowed the ball down. bad mental state.
I think Georgia might have been trying to get the referees to call a foul.
Take a look at Justin Johnson. Gets the foul he wanted.
This is a major run here by Alaska. Fueled by quick lineup. They're getting the job done in defense.
That's correct, but they're gambling. In the first half, they gambled and didn't work. Now they've gambled a couple times to score, hit from behind. Before, they go from behind and the guy would not put the steal, and all of a sudden they penetrate to the basket.
It's not just a situation of being complacent on the part of the Sunkist. It's just that the defense of Alaska is really creating all these turnovers as well.
But they are, but they're gambling, all right? And the gamble is paying off. If they miss the gamble like they did in the first half, then it turns into easy baskets.
Two big changes here by coach Derek Kumarin. Rick Marata checking in for Boybitz Victoria. Nelson Asaitona for Yoyo Villamin.
I think Derek's read that Victoria, as you were mentioning, Kanika, before, was having a little ego problem with Johnny.
That's right.
And
he probably feels he's in the flow. But I think more than that, he probably just wants two pairs of fresh legs on the floor because he needs good stamina from his players to beat this double team and this trap of Alaska.
A Saitona soars, he is hammered in the air. Lastimosa is in the party second foul. By the way, Alaska is in the penalty already. Sunkist has three team fouls. We're at the 6:22 mark of this third quarter of game six.
And that's one thing about Nelson Asaitona, is that he will not be shy to put up the shot. And at this stage, Sunkist looking for offense to be able to stop this Alaska juggernaut.
And sometimes you get the feeling, even if there were at least 10 more people in the air with him, he'll still go for it.
And we were talking about it, Kanika mentioned it, the rhythm and the flow of the game was in Alaska's favor. Now,
yes,
they've stopped the flow with Jogo going to the foul line and now Asaitona going. Now the flow is going to change here, probably. Alaska needs to score here. They need to get a good shot.
The pass deflected. It will stay with the red and white side.
The rhythm in their favor, the four going to them. If they miss here and then Sunkist goes down and score, then everything shifts.
Jonas Mariasso. Shot clock at 12. Middleton, there's a foul. Fourth with Sunkist as a team. Saitona collects his second. We're at the midway point of this third at the 6:07 mark.
Twice in the game, a handle was penetrated, got fouled, and made the pass instead of putting the shot up to go to the foul line.
Yes. Jeffrey. Johnny. Bong. Penetrates. 7-point lead.
Good movement in the offense, Ron, as far as Alaska was concerned that time.
Doesn't look like Jeffrey wants to shoot the basket.
Yes, that's clear.
No pressure on the ball if you're going to front.
Here comes Alaska.
Again, the turnover, fueling the fast break attack.
Jonas shifting directions. Can't shoot. Goes to Johnny. And it looks like a 3-second violation.
The same referee didn't call it one end, he calls it at the other end.
But we were talking about the Sunkist through the transition defense. That time, the Orange Shooters came back quickly and stopped the possible 2 points in transition.
Marata escapes! Johnny apologizes.
That's a 4-point turnaround. Alaska had numbers, should have gotten an easy basket, and they give up an easy basket.
At that time, the defense of Alaska was scattered. Not enough time to stop Marata from getting the 2 points underneath.
Instead of being five, it's nine.
In a series like this, yun mga difference kuminsan. And the foul was on Meneses, number two on the aerial Voyager.
Johnny should penetrate their penalty. Jojo or Hamilton, they should penetrate their penalty.
Both teams are in penalty. Escargasso has that in mind. It's good. However, Grandison takes it away. 4:40 to go.
Somehow the Alaska momentum stopped here.
The mood of the game has shifted again.
That's right.
It's because the
Basketball, as we've always said, Coach, is a game of spurts.
That's right.
Off the rebound, the foul.
That's penalty. They should be shooting.
Penalty situation.
Well, finally, someone put a body on somebody, I guess. There it is. That right.
Rhea Lubick collecting the foul there. His second. 4:25 remaining in the game.
More important than that rebound, Seven, wrong. It was Ronnie Granderson missing the shot from up close.
That's correct.
By the way, if you just joined us, it was a 16.3. Dodger missing the free throws. The free throw.
Yes, I want to take advantage of this large wish. Our good friend, Gary Pascua, the editor of Sports Weekly Magazine, birthday
happened.
Here, closing time to San Martin and Marteso. So, wish you a happy birthday and more to come.
They're trapping.
Marata trying to break it. Hamilton is on Marata.
Yes. The trap produced quite a number of turnovers on Sunkist. Alaska going to that same defensive tactic.
And why not?
Yes.
Granderson rejected.
5 seconds on the shot clock.
One of the rules we talked about, double team Ronnie Granderson when he's at low post.
Saitona with three on the shot clock. Hamilton out of play. And with 4 minutes to go, it's a 10-point lead once more for the Orange Juicers. Alaska suits for time.
Good timeout.
Balloon is asking the other, do we call tonight? As we know, those belong to Sunkist. They've been there since Sunday. However, I'm sure Alaska's balloon supplier is interested to find out if they will have some work come Friday. Anyway, here comes Les Limosa. We're stepping out of an Alaska timeout.
Big basket. Tim Cohen's going to have a big decision here. Is he going to sub? He's got some of the momentum. He's gained back, but when is he going to sub these guys through?
There's 3:30 left here in the third period, and another turnover forced in Sunkist.
Do you really think he's thinking of resting them at this point?
Well, you've got to have them rested for the last 6-8 minutes of the fourth quarter. You don't want to go down the stretch to have the points. The question is, do they go the whole half?
3:15 to go. Alaska trying to be a little more patient, bringing the ball around. Good shot despite the miss.
And here's Ben Jimenez in open court, but doesn't have the numbers.
Wisely decides against Rossi of the issue. It's an 8-point lead with 3 minutes to go.
That was a big miss.
Yes, and missing the Alaska Mazar.
Granderson forced to kick it outside. The shot clock is reduced to 6. Jimenez. Doesn't work. Hawkins snares it against Rhea Lubick.
Great pass, terrible defensive transition on San Francisco. And a terrific pass by Johnny.
But that's what Carriazo does best. He's a very good finisher, Ron.
Marata is flipped in the air. He saw the opening. He was thinking basketball the way there.
Marata was taking matters into his own hands. Take a look at this move by Richard Marata. He wants to match speed for speed. Rick Marata going to the line and having closer.
Lastimosa picks up his third foul in that sequence.
Yeah, Durandes works out the Rhea Lubick.
And Rhea Lubick replaced by Durandes. And a much smaller lineup on the floor for Sunkist.
Tim's winning the battle of the substitution right now, the matchups. But Johnny must be funneling Marata because Marata got a layup going sideline, baseline. He turned the ball over doing the same thing, and now that play. So they must be forcing to the sideline in this
one. 8-point lead by the Orange Juicers.
A potentially explosive lineup for Sunkist. Vanessa's playing together.
Tantabasa Kono also there. Good shot in slow.
It's a foul.
But we're going to start with Sunkist. It's in the penalty.
It is very personal.
With third foul of Asaitano. Just to mention here, the penalty was in effect against Sunkist at the 4:58. 2 minutes earlier, it was up against Alaska. Hamilton on the strike, 2:08 remaining. Chess game continues for the coaches here.
They get a free throw away. Come on, Dick, out there.
That's 3 points they've given away this half of foul shots. That one and JoJo's two misses. And it takes away their half-court trap after the main foul shot also. That was a big mistake.
Just isn't as effective, coach, when you come lay in bound from the sideline.
It's just something you don't practice.
And the ball was in the hands of Johnny. I touched it, then I lost it.
That was a lucky break for Sunkist, because Alaska had the steal, but good hustle on the part of Sunkist to have the steal. Look at the turnovers here in the third period. Sunkist collapsing into errors with 8 against 3 for Alaska. Lastimosas missed again, Ron.
Double on Daniel Meneses. Very quick to find the man inside, Ronnie Grandison, doing what he does best. As you were saying, Ron, he certainly knows how to find the openings and slide himself in up close.
Back to a 10-point lead.
I think Alaska can only keep knocking on the door so many times to get this thing down to 6-5-4. They're going to break either from fatigue or from mental
exhaustion.
This combination that Coach Kimbo has employed has not changed since the start of this game.
And they're beginning to miss.
Fatigue is setting in. This is what we talked about very early in the game, about the deep bench in Sunkist, and it's coming to fall right here in the first series.
And bailing them out of trouble time and again. And Alaska wants to regroup with a minute to play here in the third.
Basket, they need that. They've played hard, they've done a lot of good things this quarter, and the dent is not that big.
That's right, it's hit on 11 point margin.
They had their chance, but fatigue set in.
Anderson goes up, no ball to work, but there's a foul. It's on Johnny. You will rarely see Johnny go play, but that time. Something to say.
But Alaska looking for another nice pass here from Nelson Asaitono. And it was a great cut by Granderson.
Yes.
Sealing off. I mean, he's taking him to school underneath the basket.
Yes.
And how to get position.
And of course, you've got to put Asaitono exactly when you drop off that pass.
I think the totality of this game is becoming so deceptive. The opponents say, he's not going to do anything. Before you know it, he's burning you. 73-61.
Granderson's not a very talented player, but he's a great player. I mean, his athletic ability is nothing to Hamilton, but he really knows how to play the game.
Well, at the age of 30, he made the New York Knicks lineup last season in the NBA as a free agent. And that really, I think, is an indication of his smarts.
Hamilton ending up the challenging two defenders. 2 seconds to go. Okay, Alaska will have 12 more minutes to try and force a game 7, while on the other hand, Sunkist wants to celebrate in the next 12 minutes. We'll be back for the fourth.
violation.
Alaska's first offensive here in the fourth ended up being unable to be lunch rated in 24 seconds.
That's right, and some new players on the floor here for Alaska. Lastimosa sitting down, same with Barrientos, and we're talking about the fatigue factor in the third period. I think Coach King Kong recognizes that he wants to preserve his two key stalwarts for the stretch run.
Asaitono tries to pick up Balingit for the follow.
Balingit came in at the start of this fourth period for Kevin Terendez.
But it might not be a stretch run. He better get his players coming in. And an offensive foul on Hamilton.
Things not looking good here for Alaska as we begin the fourth and final period.
With the way the game has gone, so critical for Alaska these first few minutes of the fourth quarter.
That's why I was talking. I think the substitution should have came in the third quarter when they were close.
40.
So you sub through. Now you can't even afford to sub anymore. You gotta go with these guys. If you fall any further behind, you're dead.
13-point lead. Still a lot of basketball time left.
Yes. Marata. Really a lot of time here in the second half.
Yes.
Five on the shot clock. Rahel is aware of it now. Decides to shoot. Yes. How deceptive. So sly.
And you might say that was a monster basket by Rahel Meneses, because that certainly a morale booster for Sunkist and a dampener for Alaska.
15 points. Is that? Oh, boy. Talk of a dampener.
That's three turnovers for Alaska here in this period. And Carriazo will give up the foul.
Foul on Jeffrey Carriazo.
Carriazo's first.
Timeout for Alaska.
Alaska will utilize a timeout with 10 and 10 remaining and down by 15. Timeouts, while Sunkist has a complement of four. Yes, why not use it?
That's right. Lastimosa's checked back in.
Hawkins.
That's right.
They're going to get killed on the boards now.
It's Costello with the foul.
Costello is first person. Second
team foul. 78-63. I'd just like to go back to that critical moment when the momentum reshifted and went back to Sunkist's way. It would have been the turning point of the second half. Although it's still early to say.
You could just tell the momentum was going to change.
Balingit with a shot that does not work. Jolas, Reed and Marata. Hamilton, cross court. No penetration at all for Alaska.
We don't also see too much motion here in the part of Alaska's offense.
Yes.
Got away with that. Might have been a push there.
There is no way that Costello is going to win this game offensively, even if there is a mismatch.
I think that the coach is just keeping Costello up for a few minutes before he puts Johnny Barrientos back in.
Bonnell sees the basket. He is delivering.
And it's the inside point of Sunkist.
15. That's the lead. 9 minutes to go. Costello. Grandison tiptoes with a rebound, and somebody hung on to his arm.
And they were called a foul. I think it might be Lastimosa. Hamilton might be hurt. Hamilton limping away from the scene. And look at that again.
Costello's coming out. That was a terrible shot. He's going to come out of this game. I mean, he cannot win the game offense when he's taking an 18, 20-foot shot. That's not smart basketball.
Well, Drew Reyes is just about to check in for the next opportunity. No doubt for Morgan Costello. But that tells you also something about Daniel Barrientos. Still not being called on to check in. It's a three-on-one situation right here.
80-67, a 13-point lead. The closest that Alaska game was about 8 points.
Well, without Johnny in the game, they can't put defensive pressure on and get some steals.
As in the case of the trap that they executed earlier. tell us. Gives them a deuce. And now Derek Pomaren was utilized.
Good timeout.
22nd timeout. A 22nd timeout indeed, so we shall hang on to the air. He might, you know, just be thinking of using those more full timeouts should he need it in the end.
Without a doubt. And this breaks the momentum a little bit, and that was a great timeout.
Well, Jim Grass is now going to be checking in, and he'll give Coach Kim Cohn a fresh pair of legs in the backcourt. And if you're looking for pressure defense, maybe June Reyes coming fresh from the bench might be able to supply that for Alaska. They can put some pressure on the ball carrier of Sunkist.
Well, of the three-point guards, June Reyes is the weakest defensively.
But he might be the freshest at this point. And I think they need fresh legs.
Inbound.
There's Hamilton, didn't know his man. I mean, it's just not the end of the game.
Grandison, time remaining, 7:47. Asaitono climbs over everybody.
But that double was late. He got the ball in so deep and so easily, and he made a quick pass. I mean, it's got to come soon.
Grandison moving. Is
about good spacing. That was good spacing from Sunkist. Very close to get the pass from the man who was doubled at the low post. That's an Asaitono.
And you know the point about by Ron Jacobs earlier about the awareness, the court awareness of Ronnie Grandison. He knew exactly where everybody else was at that given moment, despite the defensive pressure.
Now, Alaska still has time to make a run.
Yes.
But Hawkins and Johnny have got to get back in the game.
81-69. The lead is 12 with 7:40 remaining. Ball is knocked out. And Wiener will sit down. Bolado steps in. So some Giants will bang against each other here.
And Wiener not a factor in this game at all.
Well, now Derek's won the contest. Tim's so worried about Belingan.
That's right, but he's had to put Bolado there to sacrifice speed.
Verhel rejected, but there was arm contact.
But we were just making that comment about Bolado coming in. And that coach Tim Cohn sacrifice speed for him. Look at Verhel Meneses speeding towards the hoop. A token attempt of defense by Jorge Lastimosa and Bolado. Not quick enough to stop Verhel Meneses giving up a foul.
Is that the guy up there, Grenet Cuista, or cameraman?
Susunod na paakit ko sa'yo, siguro yung stock exchange sa Makati.
You're talking about a cameraman who's up there at the rafters along with the balloons.
Kunan mo yung traffic ng Makati.
And he's doing such a great job. 22-69 is down here.
The ring it called for the foul. That would be just the first foul of Sunkist in this period.
Yes, compared to Alaska, that is
already a foul.
Tim's got to bring Johnny and Hawkins back in. He can't wait much longer. There's no next game.
Coach Kimber looking up at the clock. And you're right, Coach. We're wondering when Coach Tim Cohn will make his move to bring back his two key players.
Bolado undecided. Goes to Reyes. 7 and 10 remaining. Shot clock at 14. Lastimosa picked up by Grandison. Pass to wide. June Reyes went over the back.
That's backcourt.
Yes.
Look at these passes. I mean, it's really poor passing.
Jonas was off balance. Marata in the clear. Alina tried to tiptoe for it.
That's a good hustle by Hamilton.
Yes.
I mean, he got that line.
Well, he prevented an easy putback opportunity for Bonel Balingit. Watch this right here. Hamilton from behind Bonel Balingit. Balingit would have had an easy 2 points on the putback in that situation.
Balingit charged with a foul there. Balingit already with three personals. 6:40 remaining.
Okay, now they're going to get a technical. If they make it, make the basket. They're down by 10 with 6 minutes to go.
Still a 13-point lead. But I'll say they make a basket and then after this foul shot.
Yeah, they can cut it to 10 right here and they're in the game.
But coach, still no movement by the phone to bring up either Abarrientos or Hawkins with 6:32 to go.
And you can make an argument those are the two best players on the team.
But you must also be thinking that maybe there's something wrong with Johnny. Maybe he's not 100%. Maybe he might have aggravated the style injury.
Jolas.
Wow, that's a big basket because we were talking about just a 3-point situation here. Now it's a possibility that you can have 4 points on this offensive of Alaska.
I think some credit should go to JoJo. He stepped up. I mean, he's really the only guy that's looking to score.
In fact, the bulk of his points came here in the second half. Only 7 at the end of the first 24 minutes, and you see his total now.
Well, it's almost as though Jorge Lastimosa has the green light from Coach King to take over the offense.
Like outside of Cariasso, who really will they go to outside of Hamilton? All the players on the floor.
Well, Hamilton's not having a good game, and I don't think Jeffrey's a great scorer. So JoJo has stepped up. But Hawkins and Johnny have to get the game. I keep harping on it, but I mean.
Randerson forcing it inside and a foul on Cariasso. It's on Lastimosa. Let's check that. Ivan Jolas.
And the most effective Alaska player is now in danger of fouling out in this game.
Now Hawkins is taking off his towel. Just on the way in, Finito, you wanted to say?
I wanted to say, Ron, that Ronnie Grandison here has been having a heyday posting down low on Jeffrey Cariasso. You get the feeling that Coach Kinkone precisely wants Grandison to post up on Cariasso because he wants Derek Hamilton to come in on the double team. Is that a particular ploy that Coach Kinkone is doing? Is he trying to force Grandison to play where he wants him to play?
It's obvious that it's not working. I mean, Ronnie's doing anything he wants to do anytime he wants to do.
Well, he's given up the ball a few times because of that ploy.
Sure, but the guys are getting easy shots. Now, here's another decision by Tim Cohen, a tough one. He's taking JoJo off to save him from the 5 fouls.
That's right.
I don't think you do that when you're 11 points behind. You better get there.
This shot does not work. Hamilton's... rescued that particular situation. The lead is 9 with 5:45 remaining. Nuggets back in the game. Reyes on top of Victoria. Saitona, the shuffle. Applies the brakes. 6 on the shot clock.
And he smashed the face of Nuggets Victoria.
Bad judgment, and that's happened 2 or 3 times now. They've stolen the ball and they've lost it right back.
Ron, you know, I get the feeling that Johnny Barrientos will not check back into this game because if he were healthy, he should have checked back in much earlier.
I agree. If he does check back in, then there's been a bad decision.
And Victoria takes care of the second free throw. It's an 11-point advantage.
That's right. And Barrientos still scoreless in this game.
I think he's only taken one shot.
Probably seeing a less than 100% Johnny Barrientos on the floor. Probably less than 70%.
Vergel.
Well, that time he ate up the entire Alaska defense. Ron, what a move. Underneath, reverse.
23 points.
And Balabo didn't even react. He could have reacted. He could have at least tried to bother that shot of Benjamin Meneses. No reaction, uncontested defense.
Johnny shot goes awry, and it's a 13-point lead with 4 minutes and seven to go. Sunkist looking to win. The commissioner stopped. As Bonel balling it.
Carriazo just felt how heavy Bonel balling it is. And look at that here. Bonel balling it going down. Whoa. Oh my gosh. That's about, what, 250 pounds on top of you. And Carriazo certainly felt it.
Ano po? 356 remaining. The lead is 13. Bonel balling it, aims carefully. Misses, however. Custer's last stand is beginning to take shape here for Alaska.
That's right. Hindsight is perfect sight, but I don't think JoJo should have ever gone out of the game, even at the fifth foul.
He should have just gambled.
Yeah.
Going to just gamble.
That's right.
Because it was such a crucial stretch in the game. But still with 3:54 to go, this is a big 14-point lead that faces Alaska.
Deficit. I think we have to compliment the Sunkist as well for maintaining their poise in the face of that big, big rally staged by Alaska in that third quarter. They managed to keep their poise. I mean, Marata was there on the floor also, and he managed to see the gaps in the defense of Alaska.
Oh,
so
without
many
a
times.
Doubt. So back in the third period run, that lead was cut down to, was it the lowest? It, was it
just
six
about eight
or five?
It didn't reach six.
They had it at seven, and they had a fast break opportunity. They didn't get it. They came. Sunkist came back and scored the next.
Right.
That's
yes.
Right.
A lot so of it got to was about seven.
Yes. I think Sunkist deserves some credit, but I think Alaska's play, they didn't play smart at that time.
So part of it, the fatigue that was creeping in at that time.
That's right. You remember back in the third period, Coach Tim Cohn played with just five men, no subs at all in that particular period.
The shot clock for the sequence is down at 10. 3:18 remaining. Boybits sees an opening, uses the left hand for Stepanin!
And that could have been a foul on that play, but the referees did not call it. And Boybits Victoria will be happy with his 2 points. Could have been a 3-point play opportunity for Boybits. And Sunk is looking like it's on the way to the championship.
Hamilton overshoots. 2 minutes 50 to go.
Desperation time for Alaska. They're no longer making the extra pass.
And time running out on Alaska.
And Johnny Abarrientos called for the foul. Abarrientos scoreless in this game.
Foul on Johnny Abarrientos.
Not really looking for a shot, really.
Yeah, that's correct. And JoJo was carrying him. And they made a run. They still had a chance, but he got the fifth foul. Not only put him back in the game, he's out of the flow. I mean, it's over. Alaska doesn't have the capability of shooting 3-point shots to get back in.
They certainly need points in a hurry at this stage.
And meanwhile, a timeout will be taken by Alaska with 2:42 to go.
With a lineup at Sunkist House.
Back with us here at the Cuneta Astrodome. The score 92-79 with 2 minutes and 42 to go.
And the mood is very festive here at the Cuneta Astrodome.
And to some people, a bit too festive.
That's right. It depends
over
on which side you're on.
Here on our left, some very ardent Sunkist fans are up on their feet. And everybody milling around the Sunkist bench.
Looking for a 3-point shot, Alaska rolls it up not there, and they will call another foul on Alaska.
2:32 to go.
is third personal.
They don't have the capabilities of shooting three-point shots to get back.
It's not really a weapon that they have as a team.
And certainly you will need
to be able
to structure the contest when you need points in a hurry. A lot of our friends over in the north, I'm sure, watching here. Uzi TV branch in Paniki. Nandiyan po sina Atenevi,
sa Paniki,
sa Tarlac, si Fanny, Marvi, Fatima, Gemma, si Michelle, si Boya Chun.
Ito yung mga kinautangan mo.
Oh,
kaya mo pinabati.
Siya ang mga kaibigan natin sa San Nicolas Pagkasinan. Mayor Colin Rodrigo, papasyalo kami dyan. Vice Mayor Espirito.
And Alaska trying the desperation threes at this point. This is 94-79, 15-point lead.
All over but the shouting, what did you say, Coach? It's all over but the shouting, I think. Back in the third period.
So the third period really was the whole story of this game.
Well, actually, here in the fourth period, they did have some kind of a run going when the lead was down to about 9 points. And then Jorge Lastimosa was probably the hottest Alaska player. He got into foul trouble and had to sit out. You're saying, of course, you're knowing me, that you should not have sat out during that future state.
Excuse me, gentlemen, I'll just say that the last 2 minutes are brought to you by the Cummins Premium Vodka. Now that's the spirit, and they're pouring it on. But please continue.
Yeah, I'd be interested to see how many points they've scored since Jogo went out. It's not very many.
Hamilton,
when he was sitting down, pulled back into the game, just wasn't in the flow any longer.
Hamilton and Asaitono, who said that in game number three, I believe they really collided, and looks like they're very sporting about the whole thing. They've been helping each other when the other guy falls down, he's been helping the other one. Jorge Meneses now going on with the 97-78. Sunkist will win the Commissioner's Cup. Stage two of what they would want to think is their Grand Slam here, Kirito.
That's right, they are ready for a Grand Slam. And, well, we know that Tony Harris will not be back.
Is that
third conference?
Yes.
Not unless he decides to leave Cyprus, where he's currently playing, and check in with the consultants. Could be a surprise if Tony Harris will still come. But if Harris does not come, Sunkist is looking at Stevin Smith from Arizona State, his nickname, Headache. That's not a headache for his team, a headache for the opposition. Stevin Smith might come over for Sunkist in the third conference.
Johnny thinking three.
Johnny Aliento scored three!
First 3 points, first set of points by Johnny.
His first basket of the game, Johnny Aliento. You can see 900%. A little hobbled, and you know that he's lost his quickness.
Twice already, Alaska's faced Sunkist, at least for this year. If you count last year, they faced Sunkist three times in the finals. But Alaska still emerging to be one of the premier teams here in the PBA. They've made it to the finals again, but again falling short against Sunkist.
Somehow those things came before. We talked about the interior muscle of Sunkist becoming a capital. You know, they certainly maximized. I thought they did a good job in transition defense as well, but I think they did a couple of times when they really lost back to stop the break. Especially one time they didn't cut it down to five at one time. One extra pass by Alaska. I think also important that they did not commit too many mental mistakes in this game.
Especially their voice in the third quarter.
Oh, yeah. A lot of good composure. And
if that isn't grand air, I don't know what is tonight.
And that's what you call an exclamation point by Nelson Gabor Asaitono. Hanging on to the rim and his head way over the rim. I have not seen that.
Parang Boy with Victoria and Nelson Asaitono had eye contact. They said, can we do it as we rehearsed it? Oh, come on. Let's do it.
Now, ordinarily, I think it will be called for a technical foul for hanging on to the rim. Pero papabayaan na yan na mga referees because the rim is very invested here. It's almost celebration time for Sunkist.
But what I've always noticed, then, anytime there's a championship, the announcement, please clear the court because the game isn't over yet. In any event, since the championship has been decided, we will have interviews with the key personalities, the coach, of course, the key players. And we will visit the locker room, of course. The post-game analysis by our friends here, as well as Coach Yang Biao. Of course, a lot of people are asking me when the third conference will start. Do we have it?
That September 29th.
Yes, September 29th. So, mahaba itong
pagkakasyon natin. Some of the airports already in town. Lati Monroe for Shell. We understand that the
assistant coach to Norman Black.
Seb, let me ask a tough question here for Coach Ron Jacobs. Coach, if you were to put priorities, who do you think won it for Sunkist, the coach or the players?
Players always win the game.